blocking your access to the facility scanner. Come to the Vega terminal, and I'll give you what you need. It's a gift. Take it. It will give you strength, help you on your journey, if you can withstand the power surge. Cells within the facility for you. Vega, give him what he wants.
61,337 UAC members deceased. 81% of the facility is on lockdown. Demonic presence through the Mars installation is critical. According to the records, Dr. Hayden, the invasion originated in the Lazarus facility. It seems that a hell wave was activated, transforming 64% of all UAC employees into the creatures you see roaming throughout the facility. The rest were killed by the demons released from their holding cells by Olivia Pierce.
I feel I should apologize for what's happened here. Some of my employees took things too far. Olivia was the cause of all this, and I believe you will have to deal with her in time. You may not agree with our research, but know this. We exploited Hell and its resources because it was in mankind's best interest to do so. What you now see in this facility is the cost of progress. But none of that matters now.
There is an emergency in the foundry. The regulators have been destroyed and the core temperatures are now destabilizing.
They've overrun the adjacent facility. If the venting turbines aren't re-engaged, neither of us will survive the meltdown.
Diagnostics on the active Praetor suit. It appears that I can accelerate the upgrading of your arsenal by measuring your combat effectiveness. I have added a tracker to your helmet's display.
The facility will not allow you access to the turbine room unless the demonic threat level is brought down inside the foundry. Our security systems cannot be overridden.
Access granted. Gas leak start. Demonic threat reduced by 25%.
Rising.
Demonic threat reduced by 75%. Stabilized.
A primary control room has been activated somewhere nearby. It could be Olivia.
Authorization. Olivia Pierce, Alpha 402.
She has locked me out, Dr. Hayden.
She is trying to tear open the portal between our world and theirs.
You could not have saved them anyway.